Today's topic for discussion is transverse action of old stem of neetam. Neetam, it is a gymnospermic plant, and this transverse action of stem that shows secondary growth. The secondary growth in the tree-like and shrubby species of neetam is of normal type. The cambium forms a complete ring in the usual manner, and its cells divide in a horizontal manner to cut off secondary phloem towards its outer side and secondary xylem towards the inner side. The ray initials of the cambium form secondary medullary rays. The amount of secondary xylem formed is much more than the secondary phloem. The secondary phloem mother cells mature into three types of phloem. The sieve cells are arranged in uniform rows and are elongated cells with thin walls and blunt or tapering ends. The sieve areas or sieve plates occur on the end walls as well as the lateral walls. Each sieve area or sieve plate has pores that are aggregated into grooves. These groups of pores have been termed as sieve fields. And phloem parenchyma occurs in the form of distinct rows of cells that alternate with the sieve elements. They are smaller in size and are located in the corner of the sieve cells. The cells are vertically elongated, thin-walled and devoid of the starch content. Starch is absent in that cells. They look like companion cells but do not occur in the same radial row. They have no connections with the sieve cells. And another type of phloem element which occur in this neetam stem, that is albuminous cells, may occur in the radial files, or they may be scattered in the conducting phloem. They are always associated with the sieve cells and may be slightly smaller or half of the length of the sieve cells. Their diameter is, however, narrower. These cells contain an ovoid slime body which is absent in the phloem parenchyma cells. The albuminous cells have connections with the small sieve areas of the adjoining sieve cells. Phloem parenchyma cells have no such sieve areas connections. The albuminous cells have denser cytoplasmic content, an ovoid protein body and disappearing slime. The secondary xylem in neetam consists of three types of elements, that is tracheids and xylem parenchyma and vessels. Tracheids are long cells with thick and lignified walls. The lumen is narrow. They have circular border pits that are arranged in a uniserrate manner on the tangential as well as the radial walls. Xylem parenchyma cells have thin cellulitic walls. They are usually living cells with protoplasmic content and nuclei. The cells may be rounded or elongated with simple pits. And the vessels are also present in the secondary wood. These are elongated cells with tapering ends and possesses bordered pits. Bordered pits are also present. The end walls are perforated. There may be a single row of perforations in certain species of neetam. In neetam ulla, there is a single large and simple perforation at the end wall. Such conditions stimulate the vessels in angiosperms. Such condition occurs in the vessels of angiospermic plant. It has been noticed that some tracheids also possesses a row of closed border pits on their end walls. There are two vessels in which the end walls possesses some pits that are closed while others are perforated. The vessel elements increase in size, both length and the breadth. The border pits on the end walls increase in size. The border of the pit reduces in extent. The middle lamella and the torus forming a circular perforation. These perforations enlarge and fuse to form single large perforations. The vascular. This type of secondary growth occurs in neetam. In angiosperm, the vessels with single perforation are formed by the disappearance of bars from perforations of scalariform type of pitting. There is thus a difference in the mode of development of vessels in the angiosperms and neetam. This difference in the development of vessels in the two groups falsifies the belief that angiosperms originated from neetales.